what you never knew about the queens of England. Hey everyone, it's Alexa, and welcome back to another video. Let's brush up on your British history, shall we? Let's take a look at some fun facts about the women who have ruled England. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you are subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Driving with no plates. In a lot of places, it's illegal to drive without a license plate. The Queen is the only person in Britain who can drive without one, which would let her drive some of the rare classic cars she owns, should she feel like it. Among her collection is the 1965 Mercedes-Benz 600 Pullman Landaulet and the 1924 Rolls-Royce Silver Ghost. She also knows how to repair cars. During World War II, she trained as a driver and mechanic. In 1945, she was given an honorary position in the Auxiliary Territorial Service. She is the only female in the royal family to have entered the armed forces and is the only living head of state that served in World War II. Can't wait to be queen. Queen Elizabeth was clearly not a son, but she was also not the eldest daughter. She was never supposed to be queen. After the passing of her father, King Henry VIII, Elizabeth was third in line to the throne. She was behind her younger brother, Edward, and older sister, Mary. Edward didn't live long and only reigned until he was 15 years old. Afterward, Mary took the throne. After 5 years of Mary's reign, Elizabeth finally ascended the throne and reigned for 44 years. The secrets of Queen Anne. Queen Anne reigned between 1702 and 1714. Modern audiences can see Queen Anne in a different light thanks to the new film, The Favourite. Directed by Yorgos Lanthimos, the movie takes a look at the relationship between Queen Anne and her favorite person at court, Sarah Churchill. Queen Anne was never formally educated on the matters of state. As a result, she relied heavily on the influence of those around her, and no one had more impact than Churchill, also known as Lady Marlborough. The movie suggests the two had a romantic relationship, though no historical evidence can fully confirm this. Two birthdays. Queen Elizabeth II was born on April 21st, 1926. This year, she'll be 93 years old. Even though her birthday is in April, the UK does not officially celebrate it until June. Monarchs born in colder months usually schedule a celebration during a warmer season. April might be warm in other parts of the world, but the temperature is still low during this time in a place like the UK. A mommy's girl. Queen Anne Boleyn was the second wife of King Henry VIII, who ended up having six wives. To marry Boleyn, King Henry had to sever ties with the Catholic Church so he could divorce his current wife, a significant political move. In the end, it wasn't a fairy tale love story for the two, and King Henry had Queen Anne Boleyn executed. Elizabeth was still a small child when her mother passed. It was impossible to show outward admiration for her mother because Boleyn was one of the most hated women in England, so Elizabeth showed love for her in subtle ways. She'd wear her mother's A pendant around her neck, as well as another necklace that had her mother's portrait next to one of Elizabeth. Mary Tudor's nickname. She was the eldest child of King Henry VIII. She ascended the throne after the passing of her only living brother. Mary Tudor was very close to her mother, Catherine of Aragon, who was also a devout Catholic. When Mary became England's monarch alongside her husband, Philip II of Spain, things were not sunshine and rainbows. The two reversed English Reformation by reinstating Catholicism as the official religion of England. Queen Mary called for the execution of Protestants. This action earned her the nickname Bloody Mary. To China. Of the 66 monarchs of England and Britain throughout 1500 years, the first of them to visit China was Queen Elizabeth II. We can't blame the first half of the monarchs. England and China are 4,800 miles apart, and it's not like they had airplanes hundreds of years ago. Queen Elizabeth II visited China on October 12, 1986, and stayed there for 6 days. It took place soon after the negotiations between the UK and the People's Republic of China in the return of Hong Kong to China. Looks are everything. Queen Elizabeth I was very obsessed with her looks. She knew that not only did she need to look put together, but as a woman, her beauty could be an advantage. It took her forever to get ready in the morning. Her ladies-in-waiting would spend up to 4 hours a day to complete her dressing and undressing. Even at a young age, Elizabeth wore wigs, most matching her natural red hair. When she grew older, she used these wigs to conceal her white hair. The more she aged, the more makeup she wore to give the illusion of youth. Queen Elizabeth is a king? While her father had multiple spouses, Queen Elizabeth never married. The public nicknamed her the Virgin Queen. The nickname suggests she never fell in love, though many people doubt that. The word is that she was very close to Robert Dudley, Earl of Leicester, Robert Devereux, Earl of Essex, and the Duke of Anjou. Others say the reason she resisted taking a husband despite all her counselors urging her was that she was actually a man. The theory was that the real Elizabeth died when she was a child. The palace couldn't find another redheaded girl, so she was replaced with a redheaded boy to keep up appearances. To us, that sounds a little bit far-fetched. Some think Queen Elizabeth may have had a condition where she could not conceive. Her first email. The first message sent from a computer to another computer was on October 29, 1969. The first ever email sent by a Queen of England was on March 26, 1976. The message originated at the Royal Signals and Radar Establishment and was a demonstration on networking technology. The House of Stuart. The House of Stuart is a royal house originating from Scotland. Robert II founded the Royal Stuart line. His descendants were kings and queens in Scotland. The last of the Stuart monarchs was Queen Anne, who was known for achieving a union between England and Scotland in 1707. The last name of the family was initially spelled as S-T-E-W-A-R-T, but was changed to the French spelling with a U because Mary, Queen of Scots, more on her soon, was raised in France. Mary, Queen of Scots. You're probably asking, if she's the Queen of Scotland, why is she on this list? Back then, and even now, there are those who believe that Mary Stuart was the rightful Queen of England. Lots of people did not recognize King Henry VIII's marriage to Anne Boleyn as legal in the eyes of God because Catholicism, the once prevailing religion of England, forbade divorce. That means that Elizabeth was considered an illegitimate child and therefore an illegitimate heir. Homeschooled. You would think that she would have attended the most elite schools in the nation, but Queen Elizabeth II was never educated at a school establishment. Instead, she was homeschooled. That doesn't mean she had an easy time. Her family hired some of the most prominent professionals to be her teachers. When she studied constitutional law and history, she was under the instruction of Henry Martin, the vice provost of the prestigious Eton College. The education of Elizabeth and her sister were under the supervision of their governess, Marion Crawford. Skip a wedding. Imagine missing a royal wedding. When Prince Harry married Meghan Markle, lots of people around the world made sure to tune in. Unfortunately for Anne Stuart, later Queen Anne, she had to miss her older sister's marriage to the infamous William of Orange. Right before the wedding, Anne contracted smallpox and was bedridden for a long time. She missed the wedding between Mary and William, who were then off to William's home country, the Netherlands. A decade later, William and Mary come back to England, but not to visit. Instead, they came back to invade England in 1688. The big night out. Princess Margaret, the Countess of Snowdon, was the younger sister of Queen Elizabeth II. She had a reputation for being wilder and more rebellious. However, maybe Elizabeth wasn't as reserved as everyone thought she was. When World War II ended, the streets of England were full of crowds celebrating. Eager to join the parties, Elizabeth and Margaret took to London and went incognito so that they could have some fun too. They had permission from their father, of course. The Queen herself confirmed this story in an interview with the BBC in 1985. Queen Elizabeth I, movie star. Queen Elizabeth II is currently the second oldest state leader that is currently serving. She ascended the throne in 1952, becoming the head of the Commonwealth and Queen Regent over the UK, Canada, Australia, South Africa, New Zealand, and Pakistan and Ceylon. She has been on the throne for 65 years and counting. Data shows that she's been queen for so long that 4 out of 5 residents in the UK weren't alive when she first became queen. Prince Philip. Just because he's married to a queen doesn't make him a king. Prince Philip remains a prince despite his wife's title. The Duke of Edinburgh has been married to Queen Elizabeth II since 1947. It may or may not shock you to know that Prince Philip and the Queen are cousins. Third cousins, but still. Before we reveal number one, we have a question to ask. One of the biggest events of the year was Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's wedding. Did you get to watch the wedding on TV? Who did it better, Meghan and Harry or Will and Kate? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. 1. The Golden Age. Elizabeth I's reign was 11 years shorter than Elizabeth II's, but 44 years is still a great accomplishment when you consider the average human lifespan was way shorter back then. Queen Elizabeth I ruled an era dubbed the Golden Age. Historians note that during this time, England became a wealthier nation. With the influx of money, the country was able to invest in fields such as exploration and the arts. Elizabeth was such a big fan of the arts that she created Queen Elizabeth's Men, a royal troupe that entertained her at court. Prominent playwrights like Chris Marlowe and William Shakespeare were also around in this era.